followed you till the end of time. Darling, all the privilege would be mine. I don't take it for granted. Love divine. I felt heaven and my world collide. You took this wounded heart of mine and put it back together. I know my imperfection. I thought I learned my lesson, that I'd never be loved by someone like you. You've changed my direction, but sometimes I still question how I was worth the love of someone like you. Of someone like you. Still question how I was worth the love of someone like you. Of someone like you.
Beautiful. tonight.
All right.
Hello. Hope I don't feel
Well, welcome on behalf of Chris and Kathleen to a beautiful day with a beautiful bride. And Chris. My name is Dave Tangwall. It's my honor to preside over the marriage ceremony. I've been asked, if you have not already, to turn off your cell phones. Just be sure that they don't embarrass you. I will call you out. Okay? Thank you very much. So as we should, in the name of the Father and of the Son, and oh, Holy Spirit, we have come rejoicing for this celebration. And now we stand with Chris and Kathleen on the day that they intend to form a home of their own. For them, this is a moment of unique importance. So let us support them with our affection, with our friendship, with our prayers as their brothers and sisters. Let us listen attentively with them to the word that God speaks to us today. And let us humbly pray to God the Father, through Christ our Lord, for this couple, his servants, that he lovingly accept them, bless them, and make them always one. Please be seated. The first reading is going to be done by Don Riker. It's already up there, Don.
This is a reading from the book of Tobit. On their wedding night, Tobiah arose from the bed and said to his wife, "Sister, get up. Let us pray and beg the Lord to have mercy on us and to grant us deliverance." Sarah got up and they started to pray. And they begged that the deliverance might be theirs. And they began with these words: "Blessed are you, O God of our Father. Praise be your name forever and ever. Let the heavens and all your creations praise you forever. You made Adam and you made his wife Eve to be his help and support. From these two, the human race descended. You said, 'It is not good for man to be alone. Let us make him a partner like himself.' Now, Lord, we know that I take this wife of mine, not because of lust, but for a noble purpose. Call down your mercy on me and her, and allow us to live together to a happy old age." They say together, "Amen, amen." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The responsorial psalm will be read by Liz Norton.
Okay. Hello, everyone. The response today is, "How good is the Lord to all?"
How good is the Lord to all?
The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in mercy. How good is the Lord to all, compassionate to all his creatures.
How good is the Lord to all.
All your works shall thank you, O Lord, and all your faithful ones bless you. The eyes of all look to you, and you give them their food in due season.
How good is the Lord to all.
The Lord is righteous in all his ways and holy in all his deeds. The Lord is close to all who call him, who call on him in good truth. How good is the Lord to all.
Okay. And the second reading, the New Testament reading, will also be read by Liz.
This is a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. "Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all my mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It's not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand. Do I really need it? Okay. Okay, buddy. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. God is love. Let us love one another as God loves us. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The gospel reading today, the gospel reading comes from the Gospel of John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love. Just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you." And this is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. You see me, Chris? Get out here more so you can see me. And then KT, get out front more and more. There you go. Again, it's my honor to preside. It actually was Chris and Kathleen who chose the readings for today. And although we did have several meetings and communications with each other, I think the readings that they have selected are going to be a wonderful reflection of what their married life will be. You know, when we meet Ms. or Mr. Wright, as obviously Chris and Kathleen have done, our language begins to change as our lives obviously change. When we fall hopelessly in love, we unselfishly and fully give of ourselves to another person. And if we are blessed, as Chris and Kathleen obviously are, that person gives likewise to us. It is when the I and the me become a we. It is the we that is the bond of love that unites two people together. This is very much personified in the Old Testament reading from Tobit. You made Adam and you gave him his wife Eve to be his help and support. You said it is not good for the man to be alone. So let us make him a partner like himself. Chris and KT, you obviously will be transformed today. You will no longer be two, but now one. And that means that every single facet, every segment of your lives as husband and wife will now be transformed by your married union. Husband and wife transformed into one flesh. You know, the Bible does not say that about any other relationship. In this life, there is no other earthly relationship which is as close and as powerful as the relationship between a husband and a wife. Never again do you need to face life alone. Every thought and act can now be shared with the one who loves you and knows you better than any other person. Truly, this will be a relationship that is giving and committed. But while their commitment to each other is obviously paramount, there's another commitment that Chris and KT are making today, and that is a commitment to God. This will be witnessed by the love and trust that they have in God and in the ideals that represent a good Christian marriage. This is emphasized in the readings that they chose from both Corinthians and from the Gospel of John. Love is patient. Love is kind. It's not jealous. It's not inflated. It's not rude. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. And love never fails. But then, of course, the ultimate commandment from the Gospel of John. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy will be complete. And this is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. So KT and Chris, I hope and pray that as the future does become the present, that you will remember and reflect your lives together and that they were and are very much representative of the readings that you chose for your wedding today. Now, in regards to a homily at a wedding, really, it's kind of like, almost like a high school commencement address. And indeed, how many of you remember your high school obviously. truly, the most meaningful homily on marriage is not one of words spoken by a priest or a deacon, but rather in actions. It will be a homily witnessed through their lives together as they will be administering to each other the sacrament of marriage. In good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, theirs will be a witness that is going to be the most profound homily that will ever be spoken about marriage. And so, as a result, I ask both KT and Chris to begin their marriage homily by writing me a letter to share with me why they have chosen to commit their lives to each other and to give themselves to this particular person in marriage. Nobody knows about these letters, do they, moms? No. This is where you're going to cry. Okay. KT does not know what Chris has written, and Chris does not know what KT has written. So to begin, KT. Chris, when people ask if I knew you were the one, my answer is honestly, no. I would like to have seen this one. You were the guy in a club that dared to eat potpourri. How did that taste, big guy? Right on. But I did know that I kept wanting to be around you. I have always been drawn to your playful, fun-loving attitude, from dancing on tables in Greece to jumping out of an airplane with me in New Jersey. You make me laugh every single day. My favorite thing about our relationship is our commitment to grow with each other. As we have grown and changed into the people that we are today, you have been my biggest cheerleader. And not just because you can high kick like Richard Simmons.
It happens, man. It happens.
I guess, yes. It's an inside thing, I guess. You have continued to love and support me throughout every season. When you lost your dad, I was in awe of your strength and the way that you channel your sadness into an opportunity to live your life more fully. Your consistent positivity and your ability to see the good in every situation is contagious. I know if your dad were here, he would be so proud of the man you've become. I love you forever, KT. Now, Chris's letter. You gotta sit back for this one. This is a tome. No, I'm just kidding. Dear Kathleen, I am so overjoyed to be with you today, knowing I'm marrying my best friend, my true love, my everything. I love looking back at how everything started for us and how what an incredible journey it was to get us to this very day. Even though we probably brushed shoulders on campus our first 2 years at Loyola, it took us a 5,000-mile plane ride to Greece and an opportunity to get lost in this big, beautiful world for us to find each other. I don't know about you, but when I was planning our time abroad, I thought the only things I was going to bring back home were some souvenir shot glasses and a Facebook photo album entitled Spring 2016. But I came back with something far, far greater than I could possibly imagine, my beautiful future wife. It's been 6 years since we traveled all over Europe, and in those 6 years, you have given me more and more reasons to love you. You light up my world. You give me strength. You lift me up day by day to be the best person that I can be. As we start our lives together, I want you to always remember those promises that I will keep throughout our marriage. He actually has them bulleted. I promise to keep exploring the world with you and enlightening ourselves with cultures and peoples like we did when we first met. I promise to help build our family and make sure that our core values and of love and acceptance are forever unchanged. I promise to love you through everything that comes our way. And I promise to always be there for you and to be a light for you in this world, just like you are always there for me. I love you more than anything in this world, Kathleen. And so I'm happy to forever be your husband. Love always, Chris. I think you got a good one there, Kathleen. See, these guys are standing here in awe, like that came out of Chris's head. What a romantic. Awesome. So that begins their marriage homily. But now we get down to, of course, the important part. And I have a very important question. I have a very important question to ask Chris. Are you ready? I can't hear you.
Yes.
In the Roman Catholic Church, the sacrament of marriage is not a sacrament that is actually performed by a priest or a deacon. It is performed by the couple themselves. So all of us here, myself included, we are witnesses to Kathleen and, you're still there, Kathleen and Chris carrying out the sacrament of matrimony. So, dearly beloved, you have come here together in the presence of the church minister and the community for your intention to enter into marriage, that it may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you through a special sacrament. He enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, I ask you to state your intentions. So Chris and Kathleen, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
Yes.
Yes.
Good. She wanted to wait for him to say it first. Okay. Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you shall live?
Yes.
Yes.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. Chris? I, Chris, take you, Kathleen.
I, Chris, take you, Kathleen.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you and to honor you.
To love you and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
KT. I, Kathleen, take you, Chris.
I, Kathleen, take you, Chris.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you and to honor you.
To love you and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Okay, Andrew.
Walk up, Andrew. Walk up.
May the Lord bless these rings, which you will now give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity. Thanks, big guy. You go back. Mm-hmm. Chris? Kathleen, receive this ring.
Kathleen, receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Kathleen. Chris, receive this ring.
Chris, receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
The prayer of the faithful will now be read by Ellen. Oops, I'm sorry. Wait a second. Very important moment here. You are now married. So, Chris, you may kiss your bride. Okay, that's enough. The prayer of the faithful will be read by Ellen Reichert.
The response is, Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray that the love of Chris and KT may grow deeper each day, and may that love strengthen and comfort them on their journey through life together. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. By this marriage, two families have been united. May both families continue to be a source of love, support, and guidance through Chris and KT's life. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray for all friends here present that God may give you peace in your hearts for today, hope in your hearts for tomorrow, and love in your hearts forever. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We remember today with a special love, friends and family members who have touched our lives and are sadly no longer with us, especially Michael Gamache. May they remain in our thoughts and prayers. Lord, bless them and keep them in your care until one day we are reunited with them in the joys of our eternal home. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray for all those who are sick, lonely, struggling in today's world. May they be strengthened by God's love and aided by friends and family. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. For our country and those who defend it, may those who serve in the military be kept safe from all harm. Lord, graciously, Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us.
Thank you. As I mentioned, we are all witnesses to Kathleen and Chris now committing themselves to each other in holy matrimony. So I would like for all of us to participate, if you would, stand, participate in the nuptial blessing. If you would extend your hands over them. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe and formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two, but now one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. Look now with favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit, and pour your love into their hearts that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace and love and peace abide in your daughter, Kathleen, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband, Chris, entrust his heart to her so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. May these, your servants, hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments. May they be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents. And grant that reaching at last together the fullness of years, for which they hope they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you both in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And now, Chris, you may kiss your bride a second time. It's now my honor to introduce for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Christopher Kamosh.
Everyone I see, just 'cause I want to.
What's up?
Can't put my finger on it, find the words to explain. I just know I want it, that thing. Give me that thing that you do. Give me that right next to you. Give me that buzzing underneath my skin again. Show me that look in your eye, and baby I think I can fly. Give me you. That thing that you do. just high on life and a little love drunk. Can't put my finger on it, find the words to explain. I just know I want it, that thing. Give me that thing that you do. Give me that right next to you. Give me that buzzing underneath my skin again. Show me that look in your eye, and baby, I think I can fly. Give me you, that thing that you do.
This time, the beautiful couple will now share their first dance together. Don't wanna get ahead myself, feeling things I never felt. It's kinda hard for me to explain. A personality and everything brings me to my knees, oh. She shines me up like gold, my own. I wanna take it slow, but it's so hard. I love to see your face in daylight. It's more than just our bodies at night. She's really tempting me, oh. Do you think I'm being foolish here for don't rush in? I'm scared to death that she might be in, that this love is real, that this shoe might fit. She might just be my everything beyond, beyond. Space and time in the afterlife. Will she have my kids? Will she be my wife? She might just be my everything beyond. I give up, I'm in love, crying. Hey, oh me, oh my, I can't explain. She might just be my everything. Oh me, oh my, I can't explain. Might just be my everything. Do you think I'm being foolish if I don't rush in? I'm scared to death that she might be in. This love is real, that this shoe might fit. She might just be my everything and beyond, beyond. Space and time in the afterlife. Will she have my kids? Will she be my wife? She might just be my everything and beyond. Oh, beyond. than for Katie and Chris, y'all. That's how you do it. That's how you do it.
I can't hear myself, so. First of all, the love in the room is just so powerful because of you two. Have to say that. So we're going to take a moment. Please join me in bowing your head to take a moment. We're going to thank the Lord for bringing us together to enjoy this meal and beautiful evening. We are so happy that so many of you could be here in person and those in spirit to celebrate this special occasion and this special, beautiful couple, Katie and Chris. Amen.
Hi, everyone. How are we feeling? Good. For those of you who don't know me, my name's Lee. I have been Katie's friend for more than 15 years, and I'm her maid of honor tonight. Katie and Chris, thank you so much for letting me be a small part of your big day. It's such an honor to be the warm-up act for Ryan's speech next. Yeah. To give you some background, Katie and I met in the sixth grade at Stone Ridge, and we instantly bonded over one particular boy band, the Jonas Brothers. Some of you in the room tonight may unfortunately remember knowing Katie and I during this time where we talked about nothing else. If you are one of those people, you may be entitled to financial compensation. We were totally in love with them. We made YouTube videos for them, which thankfully have been wiped from the internet. And we even imagined our future wedding days with our respective soulmates, Joe Jonas for me, Nick Jonas for Katie. So you can imagine my surprise seeing Chris here tonight when that was not a part of the plan. Fast forward about a decade, and the Jonas Brothers had sadly broken up, and Katie and I had moved on to bigger and better things, finally. Katie was studying abroad in Greece, and I will never forget getting a Facebook message from her on February 10th, 2016, which I went back and dug up for you all, where she wrote, "Lee, did you read my travel blog? I ate cow brain last night. Oh, and I also have a boyfriend." Incredible way to bury the lead. I immediately needed to know everything about him. And she told me his name's Chris, he goes to Loyola, and he's the perfect combination of fun and goofy. She told me he can be quiet and shy, but he dances on the tables at the bars when Hotline Bling plays. Yeah, if you don't know that song, I'm sure Chris would be more than happy to demonstrate later tonight. I responded the way any friend would, and I said, "Oh my God, he sounds so fun. Run with it. Milk it for all it's worth." 6 years, 5 months, 13 days later, I think it's safe to say she did. Yeah. A few more years down the line, Katie and I were living together in D.C. after college graduation, and I was lucky enough to see Chris all the time at our apartment. And I remember thinking that they always managed to operate with this sense of kindness and calmness, even when it wasn't easy. Chris was there to celebrate the good days, support on the bad days, and probably with a box of gluten-free pizza in his hand, either way. He attended every yoga class Katie taught. He cheered her on at a 10K she'd run at 5 a.m. or something on a Saturday morning, which I think says a lot. And I just remember thinking to myself, if there's anyone I know that deserves a love like this, it's Kate. Aww. Chris, as it turns out, you really are the perfect combination of fun and goofy. I'm so grateful that I gained a friend as good as you over the years. And I couldn't dream up a better husband for my best friend if I tried. You might not be a Jonas brother, but you're so much better. To wrap it all up, I want to share one more thing that Katie said in those Facebook messages from way back in 2016. She wrote to me and said, falling in love with Chris feels like a dream. Katie, watching your dreams come true with Chris has been nothing short of spectacular. So I'd like to raise a toast to Katie and Chris. Cheers, or yamas, as they say in Greece, yamas. To Katie and Chris, Mr. and Mrs. Gamage, to a long and beautiful life together. I love you guys.
So hello everyone. As Travis mentioned, I'm Ryan. I'm Katie's twin brother, and the man of honor, or as Andrew would say, the woman of honor. Before I get started, I want to give a big shout out to Chris's mother, Mrs. Gamash, and my parents, Mike and Teresa Norton. Thank you so much for hosting us this beautiful, beautiful wedding for Katie and Chris. So I also have a quote. She is my best friend, my moral compass, my biggest responsibility, and my main source of worry. She is my twin sister, Katie. So that fine quote came from my college admissions essay. So Katie got me into college. There's a lot to unpack in that opening line, but the first descriptor I used was my best friend. And from the beginning, Katie and I were partners in crime. I was the worrier, as you can probably tell. The rules guy. Katie was cool, calm, and collected. My earliest memory was a ski trip, our family ski trip. I was probably 2 or 3 years old. And since Katie and I couldn't walk, we were taken to the daycare. Before Mikey and my parents hit the slopes. And Katie was quick to devise a plan for our escape. We were hiding in the playhouse until the babysitter turned to look at another infant. And we made our break for it. Waddling out of the playhouse through the door halfway to the corridor until we were scooped off our feet and placed in the crib, which had a perfect view of the slopes where we could see my parents and Mikey. So now it was time for my plan. We pounded on the window, screaming, until we were rescued. And it worked. Next, I describe Katie as my moral compass. And it's true, Katie really has been a moral compass for Mikey and me. Often growing up, I would ask myself, what would Katie do? Or what would Katie want me to do? And to this day, she is my go-to when I need real, honest advice. One of the qualities I've always appreciated and admired about Katie is her strength and her innate sense of self. She never lets what others think impact the way she lives her life. In grade school, when a teacher went around the room asking everybody what their favorite food was, all the other girls said normal things like cookies, cake, pizza. But when it came Katie's turn, she didn't hesitate and she replied, "My favorite food is cream spinach." And we learned that Chris is potpourri. No, but it's true. As my Uncle Jerry would say, Katie likes what she likes. Moving on to the more cringy part of my essay, where I describe my sister as my strong and independent sister as my biggest responsibility and my main source of worry. I can practically feel Katie rolling her eyes. My biggest responsibility. Mikey and I were the annoying heroes that no one asked for. The overly protective brothers. It's no wonder Katie had to fly halfway around the world to meet the love of her life. No, seriously, it's like destiny was avoiding having the two of them meet while they're on the same continent as Mikey and me. But we're also happy that they did meet and that they fell in love. On the one hand, Mikey and I could not have asked for a better new brother. For those of you who don't know, Chris is a great cook and a subpar golfer. I'm kidding, he's a good golfer, but more importantly, he has completed our father-son foursome. Chris is also very creative and has a great sense of humor. This is evidenced by the fact that every time my family plays Yahtzee with Chris, my mom is practically falling off her chair in laughter. Chris is incredibly kind and patient, which is the only explanation for how he was able to live under the same roof as my family for 2 months during a global pandemic. But above all, Chris doesn't think of Katie as his biggest responsibility or his main source of worry. He sees her for the strong, intelligent, vibrant, and capable woman that she is. Instead of taking on the role of Katie's protector, although we all know he could protect her, Chris is Katie's greatest supporter and teammate. He trusts that she, above anyone else, knows what's best for her. And at the same time, Chris challenges her and encourages her to reach her full potential. To make a short story long, Chris emulates the purest and more emotionally intelligent version of the sentiment that I tried to convey in my essay so many years ago. The idea that when you love someone, it's natural to worry about them because you care so much. But too much worry can cloud that love. Like my knee to the groin of some middle school boy pursuing Katie at a dance. Seriously, it's a tough balance to strike, but Chris walks the line with ease. Chris, I love you like a brother, and I know I speak for the entire Norton, Boyfer, Robertson, Brown, Gessler, French, Cimbolo, DiMartino, Castle, Versace, and Bowie families when I say we feel so incredibly lucky to have you joining our family. Also, I have to say, what an incredible family you come with. I've had the pleasure of spending a lot of time with many of the Gamaches this weekend. Sorry, I didn't catch everyone's last names. But you guys are awesome, and we're so happy and lucky to be able to call you all family as well. Finally, I'd like to ask everyone to raise a glass with me for a few final words. I'm almost done, I promise. Katie, Chris, Hollywood could not have written a better match. Whether you're defending Uncle Bob at a Ravens game. Long story. Laughing until you cry while playing board games, or being the life of any party with a dance floor. Looking forward to that high kick later tonight. You make every gathering better for the rest of us. Together, you are incredible dog parents to Norm, and I know you will make great human parents one day too. You are exactly what every couple aspires to be. Compassionate, loyal, supportive, fun, but most importantly, you're so in love. Love you guys. Congrats. And cheers to the newlyweds.
Everyone, good evening. For those of you I have not yet met, my name is Tim. I'm the oldest of Chris's brothers. How old, you might ask? So old that Chris didn't invite me to the bachelor party because he feared it might bring down the coolness quotient. Oh yeah, Chris, that's where this is going. Buckle up. You'll notice I didn't get introduced or introduce myself as Chris's best man. That honor goes to a good fellow right here that you hear from shortly. They asked me to say a few words on his behalf before a great celebration. We're going to have that in a second. But first, I wanted to give my baby brother and his new bride a few other words of wisdom. Chris, do not ever give your older, better looking, smarter, funnier brother any permission to steal the mic at your own wedding. Why would you ever do that? KT, Gamache males can only make one smart decision per day. Today, you were it for Chris. Stop right there. Cut it out. KT, you remember that night? We're at Scott's wedding. We had dinner and we're polished off a bottle of rum with the waiter and the chef. Remember that? And it's one of the two says, he looks like Captain America, Chris Evans, right?
Yeah.
And we're like, that went straight to his head. I know. Remember that? Stay with me. Well, the benefits of being an older significant, an older brother, are that you know the origin story. So get ready. Ready? When my brother Scott was born, my mom and dad showed me how much they love me by getting me a new bike. When Andrew was born, I got a water pistol shaped like a spaceship. When Chris was born, I got to dig out of the blizzard of 95 and a slice of pizza from Conti's in Princeton. It was good pizza, but we were off to a bad start. All right. I soon learned that little brothers have novelty value. If you attach a piece of tape to Chris's fingers when he's one, he can't quite get it off. You know what I'm saying? Like this. Now, it got a little rough. We wrestled on mom and dad's bed all the time. I broke your forearm. There's a purple cast involved. That's all I really remember about that. I tried to see if a tennis ball would fit in your mouth. I popped out your two front teeth. It got better from there. There's a Gamache family tradition when we were young. Saturday night, 5 o'clock, mass. 6 o'clock, Alfonso's pizza. 7 o'clock, we're playing soccer with a Nerf ball in the family room. Until something or someone would break. I would dribble around like this. Chris would chase me on the outside until he got dizzy and fell over or got so sweaty he had to take off his Palmeiras soccer jersey and throw it on the ground to keep up. I love you, Chris, for never, ever giving up, all right? You're a champ. I got older. I moved out, right? College, work, all that stuff. But I came home. I saw Chris when he wasn't playing sports. He was strewn out on our couch in our family room, watching ESPN, memorizing sports statistics, or maybe some comedy show or movie. So you know all the quotes, you know? Like, that's what he does. You guys know what I'm talking about, right? He kind of kept that shape for a while, even though he was getting taller and taller. So he left for school with this, like, hunchback situation going on. This voicemail that said, hey, this is Chris, leave a message, because he never changed it. And this hair that was, like, so overgrown, it was ridiculous, over top of which he put these headphones, like those Beats, those things, like, he was so cool. Now, I would come back from time to time. He'd still be, you know, like, doing that couch situation. There was one time I came home, things were different. It was right after he got home from Greece. He stood up straight. He looked me in the eye. He shook my hand. He gave me a big, big bear hug. The hair situation, we can't win them all, Chris. I mean, that's all right. I get it. I got a guy. Let me introduce you to Mario. All right. Now, a lot of people attribute that change to KT. And you know what? I can't disagree. You're so, so sweet. You're sincere. You're funny. You're youthful. You're energetic. You're fast. Like, everything she does, like, I can't keep up. Like, that's the cool part about my new sister-in-law. So, thank you for taking good, good care of my brother. Now, guys, there's a lot of world out there. You've seen a lot of it so far. But when you go out from now on, you set it ablaze, just like you have been, all right? You teach this world what your values are all about. And whether you're tossing coins in the Trevi Fountain or you're snorkeling in the Maldives, I want you to remember that home is where you two are together. So I love you very much. Everyone, raise a glass to the new bride and groom one more time, to Chris and KT.
Oh yeah.
some enchanted evening, you may see a stranger. You may see a stranger across a crowded room, and somehow you know even then, that somewhere you'll see her again and again. Some enchanted evening, someone may be laughing, you may hear her laughing across a crowded room, and night after night, as strange as it seems, the sound of her laughter will sing in your dreams. Who can explain it? Who can tell you why? Fools give you reasons, wise men never try. Some enchanted when you find your true love, when you feel her call you across a crowded room, then fly to her side and make her your own. Never let her go. Once you have found her, never let her go.
Deserve it so much. Congrats. Now on to the honeymoon.
Hey
congratulations you two, Chris. Always nice to see you and the other your other brothers. Have a fun life together. Let's do more gatherings.
Hi guys. Thank you for inviting us to your wedding. We had a great time. Thank you for including Uncle Don and I in your ceremony. It meant so much to us. I hope you have a wonderful time on your honeymoon and happy life wherever it takes you. Bye.
Thank you for sharing your night with us. We're having a grand time. And God bless and good luck and keep that Kamash tradition going. Love you. Bye.
Aye, golly, what a wonderful night. What a wonderful event. How fabulous it is for both of you to have found each other, and we wish you all the happiness in the world. On behalf of all the Weinbergs, I'm proud to be here, and all I can say is that we love you both, and we certainly wish you much joy.
Hey guys, congrats.
Hey, no, hey guys.
DJ, that's all I'm saying.
Hey guys!
Alright, so I think you guys are wonderful together. good luck with life. You can
Had a great time. Just finished the cake.
Yep. All around, excellent wedding.
Beautiful.
My name's Felicia, and I'm here to say you guys are getting married all the way. And I don't have any lines, and I don't know how to rhyme, so I'm going to pass the mic to Daniel.
My name is Daniel. I don't know what to say. I'm here to say, Wes's turn. Wes's turn.
Light it up. Freestyle it.
My name is, it's not even on me.
Oh, alright.
My name is Wes. I'm here to say, we're going to go portal.
Great marriage, but I'm not going to congratulate you again this year, Stuff, because you're not going to the finals.
Stuff, this is a champions only banquet. He's my plus one, and this is my plus two.
What about me? I'm a champion.
And here's the other champion.
Yeah.
And here's the other champion. Here he goes, right here. There he is. My plus one and my plus two.
Trump was so.
I'm here for Trump. I love you too.
Congratulations, you guys.
Congratulations, we love you. You know, the most important thing is a long, healthy, happy marriage. And Chris, just know, as a wise man once said, your wife is always right. And that's what all the cheesy people always say. But I still haven't learned that. Love you.
Thank you.
ago. I was her number one. She told me a song, but she still means the world to me. Just so you know, so be careful when you hold my girl.
Stop the sound. You will never stop the sound. too high and we won't come down. Devoid of all temptation can be the declaration. Yeah, left, right, girls, boys, ignite the spark, be heroes, ridding of your ego. Oh, don't let me fall, I won't let you go. We just gotta let them know. Everyone's together now. Stop your voice to stop the sound. You can't stop us now. We're up too high and we won't come down.
Take my whole soul too. Every last night, chasing our dreams, the city is ours. Like wolves that come out at night, we run through the dark and you hear us howling. Shadows dancing, hands up to the sky, throw our sorrows in the ring of fire. About time, get lost in each other. Shadows dancing, hands up to the sky. Throw our sorrows in the ring of fire.
With you, unless it's with you, with you, with you. is with you. Unless it's with you.